Kevin here. Welcome to Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. So, a few things to address here. You may notice something different. The background looks kind of different. Well, that's because I'm over at a family member's house trying to find a job over here. Because where I used to live and such, the job I'm looking for, they weren't even hiring. So, yeah. But everything's going to be fine. Everything's all right. Right. So, let's get into it now, shall we? Mortal Kombat 3. Well, Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. What is Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3? It's basically Super Street Fighter 2 Mortal Kombat 3. They updated the game, added some new characters, and retweaking and rebalanced some of the other characters. Right, so, however, Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3 somehow got rid of the intro for Mortal Kombat 3. Don't know why or how. Probably space reasons or something. I don't know. But through the power of editing, I'll give you the intro right here. Welcome back. That was Mortal Kombat 3. So, with all that being said, let's ask the question, what happened ever since Mortal Kombat 2? Well, and there you go. So, without dilling or dallying, let's get back into Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. Right, sorry about that. Alrighty, so let's get into it. We have to play as everyone's favorite turkey boy. Alrighty. Gonna be playing on Warrior because I'm still a weenie. This game, I like its gameplay mechanics. It's so much better in certain aspects because of the combos. You can actually chain combos and such, and that's what I like about this game. It kind of becomes more of the standard fighting game, the modern fighting game way of combos. See what I mean? And that's completely different. There we go. So, I like this new fighting mechanic, how it kind of changed combos and such like that, but it's not as easy. I mean, it is kind of easy compared to the other Mortal Kombat games, but I'm still weenie because I kind of suck at this game.
You suck.
Ah, damn it. Wins. It was 4-4. Down.
Round one.
Whatever. Fight. Alright, I'm gonna say this. I love the designs of the minions in Mortal Kombat 3. Oh, no, it's in Mortal Kombat 3. These designs are my favorites. I like these designs of the ninjas until they literally gave the ninjas their own kind of unique personality and design. Like Urrex costume and Deadly Alliance, or not Deadly Alliance, Deception, that looked pretty cool for itself. Scorpion and Sub-Zero's looked pretty cool. Yeah, when they start getting their own design and such, yeah, they all look great, but all of them look at the same being palette swaps, I like these designs the most. Alright, yep. Let's do this again. Liu Kang. I really hate the fact that Liu Kang is all the way at the bottom of this one. Fight. Shit, I keep screwing up his 6-8 combo. This is one of the new characters in Mortal Kombat 3. And yeah, she's a forearm Shokan. She's a female Shokan, I guess you could say. And yeah, you can tell I don't like Shokan. For that move alone!
Excellent, Shiva.
People of Outworld, I guess you could say Shang Tsung is from Outworld. But yeah, everyone from Outworld just has a Shokan as they embody, or ironic, ain't it? Well, scratch that, because Sindel was from Adenia, not Outworld, but yet then she had Shiva as a personal bodyguard. Ironic, ain't it? I guess you could say anyone with royalty or, you know, high authority, they just have bodyguards who are four-on half dragons. Damn it! Wins. Round three. Fight. Oh, I'm sorry, there's 8 hits.
Crispy.
I love it how the skeleton only has 2 arms and yet she's supposed to have 4. Nah, whatever. It's Mortal Kombat 3. Who cares? Nightwolf is another one of the new characters who is a defender of Earthrealm. And he's actually kind of ridiculous. He's actually really good.
Round 2. Fight.
Wins. Now, fun fact about this game. There is a glitch, graphical glitch, that screws up the character select screen and sometimes the Choose Your Destiny screen if you unlock all three of the secret characters. And this version is no exception, it does it. Now, of course, this is the regular arcade version, so what am I talking about?
Round two, fight.
Well, I guess you could say the PlayStation 2 version of Mortal Kombat Deception? No, it was, Armageddon. Yeah, I want to see if it was Armageddon that actually had Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, because Shaolin Monks had MK2 and Deceptive had MK1 in the collector's edition for the game. Well, not Shaolin Monks. Shaolin Monks did have a collector's edition. There we go. Oh, yeah, it was a set of kids. But of course, for some reason in this game, the AI just have an advantage that their combos do a little bit more damage than you. Why? Because one of Sub-Zero's combos, on your side it only does 23%, but on theirs it does about 30%. Oh no, I screwed up the combo! Damn it. Okay, yeah, I forgot he, reflects charges, fireballs. Unlike Jade, who can just make them all phase through her, no pun intended. This is the only fatality I kinda know, and it's kinda the easiest to do. The other one is up, down, up, up, block, and run. Which, actually, you think about it, actually, it's not that bad, but yeah, let's try it again. I remember trying it once, it didn't work out so well. Agent Kamal, you're kinda one of the most ridiculous overpowered characters in this game.
Round two, fight.
Okay, yeah. I thought if they were gonna do that to me in Ultimate Mortal Kombat, I thought I'd do it back. No! You suck, come on! I Alright, so another question I should ask you. What version of Mortal Kombat did I play? PlayStation, Nintendo 64 version? Or, yeah, because I can't get the arcade work. I can't get the arcade version working properly. And I cannot, get a PC version. So yeah, PlayStation or Nintendo 64, let me know. Okay, well, that works. Oh, Kung Lao is really cool in this one. I like his design in this one. I like the poses that he does in this one. Really cool. But I kind of prefer the Damian Lions costume more. The one without the hat on. I think that looks cool. I know people always see Kung Lao with the hat on and such, but I always like it when, you know, they change it to where he doesn't have the hat on. This is just personal preference, because I still like Kung Lao with his hat on and such. I just feel like the costume of Damian Lions kind of deserves a little bit more. Damn it. Oh shit, it's run, down, run. Oh shit, I'm sorry, I'm looking at fatality. Alright, endurance matches, you remember the Mortal Kombat 1? Yeah, they make a return on this one. And I do not like this one. Especially for the fact that, you know, this is Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. And I hate Jack just throwing this one, like, good lord.
Round 2, fight. Well done.
It's so weird playing with Liu Kang with his combo that it requires block as a button you need to press. Fatality was kind of dumb. This version of Mortal Kombat usually just has some of the dumbest fatalities that just make no goddamn sense. Example, Jax has one when he turns humongous and it just stomps you. It was like,
fight. Well done.
Alright, so far so good. Oh crap. Couldn't do any other fatality. That's the only one I could do, but run away.
Toro.
I hate this sub boss. For one reason like that. And that reason alone, he can literally do something on the second hit of your combo. Okay, yeah. It's really kind of pointless to use any fireballs, because fireballs just bounce off of them and. Yeah. First round done. Second round, whatever. Sometimes Voltron likes to do something else, and yeah. Seems to be like bosses, like sub bosses are literally the ones that always give you enough trouble. Switch to the drop kicks because they seem to be the most effective. I hate doing that, but it seems to be effective. Fight. Fireballs of his though. Funny fact, if both players are playing as Voltaro and they shoot fireballs at each other, they're just gonna bounce off of each other. It's kinda hilarious. Yes! Alright! Alright, on to Shao Kahn. I don't know what's more hard, this Shao Kahn or Mortal Kombat, to be honest. And that hammer, though. Oh. Oh, okay, I was about to say, hey, Shao Kahn. Why wasn't the low kick going out? kind of had the controls more or less set up like how I did in the Super Nintendo one. Kind of. I really don't have to do Shao Kahn talking to me now anymore because he's doing all the work for me. This is hilarious. Ow. Okay, that wasn't hilarious. This is the hard part. Shao Kahn, because you seem to cheat a lot in this game, especially you just shoulder charge it. Can you do anything else and then want to do fireballs? Taking me off, Shao Kahn. You're really taking me off. Okay, never lie. When he freaking shoots a fireball. Man, what happened this time? Last time I was working pretty well, now it's not.
fight.
Get him. Yes! Alright, that round's done. One more to go. Let's do this. Dang, he's ruined it. Now, of course, right. Fuck you, Shao Kahn. You ruined everything. Alright. Until then, folks, we will see you in the next part of Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3.